Hey, what's up, guys? Nee here. So I'm here with Admin and Contractor for Apocalypse Rising 2, Zealiant. So Zealiant, how about you go ahead and tell me a little bit about yourself?
All right, so I started playing APOC July 2012 because it's when the game really kind of came out in the alpha for Kin Classic. Ever since then, I've actually been playing the game. I've been a big fan of the game, and I've been following the community as well as kind of stalking Gus at the beginning. And so, hey, here I am. So I guess it worked.
All right, so what exactly do you do for Apocalypse Rising 2 development?
So Nairobi, Gus, and I, we all really kind of make the buildings, we furnish the buildings, we make furniture for the buildings, and then we place loot within the buildings. So originally, multiple contractors would actually design the buildings, and then it was our job to make furniture, furnish the buildings, and then add loot within the containers and whatnot.
So I have a few questions here about Apocalypse Rising 2. So we're going to be doing this Q&A, and basically here I'm just going to be asking him some questions about Apocalypse Rising 2. So let's go ahead and start here with this first question here. So what are your favorite things about Apocalypse Rising 2 so far?
I mean, there's a lot of cool things. Probably my favorite thing is the fact that it really is a new game and that we've all been able to come together to create it. Because APOC 1 was really just Gus and Keth until Keth left and people came in and all this stuff happened. But APOC 2 is just our chance together to create something really awesome.
So this is a question about aircraft. Do you think it would be cool if Apocalypse Rising 2 had airplanes or helicopters, like maybe a one-seater airplane or helicopter or even multiple seats?
In terms of aircraft for APOC 2, helicopters are something people have been asking for and something we've joked around about. Airplanes? I can't really see airplanes being in there as just because of the speed that they travel at and the fact that you kind of have to land it. So it doesn't really fit the play style of APOC 2 compared to something like a helicopter where you can actually just land it, pick up, people lob you, it can actually attach maybe armament to it. I don't know, because helicopters currently, you know, aren't being created. But I think helicopters would be good if they were done well and they fit the gameplay.
What do you want to see with a watercraft in Apocalypse Rising 2? Like, what would you want to see added and what would you want to see basically like with it?
I think a destroyer would really fit into the game, you know, balance and, you know, no, but stuff like jet skis, you know, maybe a dinghy, like something to make it easier to get from one place to another rather than using the road, which someone might be like sitting at watching. So I think it's just like kind of smaller watercraft that will help you to get from place to place.
And I honestly would like to see like a larger boat somewhat added. Like we do have vehicles that should fit more people. But like, you know how we have the Urals that can fit like 8 people, I think? Maybe a boat could fit that many people.
Yeah, I understand.
Yeah.
So, I mean, yeah, in that case too, because it would probably be a little bit rarer how I see it, because you want it to be kind of a special purpose kind of thing.
So what do you like the most about the interior of buildings in Apocalypse Rising 2?
The coolest thing about the interiors is the fact that they have interiors, because, I mean, APOC 1 didn't have any furniture. Mm-hmm. And you just walk into it, it's just an empty building with loot on the floor. It was good for optimization, but being able to add furniture and an actual interior design of a building is really cool, because it makes, well, not only does it make more sense, but it's just cooler and it's nicer. And if it's well optimized, it's perfect.
What would you like to see added in Apocalypse Rising 2? Pretty much anything here. And what would you like to see like in the game?
One of the things I love the most about any game is Easter eggs. And Gus could even like attest to this, that I've said the word Easter eggs plenty of times when we were building and stuff, just because I love giving the player the ability to go around and find something and be and like making a connection to it or seeing it and be like, hey, that's pretty good.
Exactly. Yeah. iDubbbz reference. Yeah.
Yeah. I'm not sponsored, by the way.
And so Easter eggs is the main thing. Anything else? Probably a lot of other things, right?
Anything and everything. New weaponry, a better sense of combat. I mean, like all this stuff is almost kind of like already coming, but it's just like, I can't really add that much to it because the game is already good. And I fear that me wanting something
change the perfect product. Maybe.
Exactly. It might ruin it. It might disbalance it. So I think what Gus is doing is perfect because he knows what he's doing.
Yeah, just seeing the alpha map and everything, that had me like, wow, I can actually see how players will have a good experience here and they'll add more like of the map as time goes on. What are your thoughts on the animations in APOC 2?
Again, this is one of those things where I'm happy there are animations because APOC 1 didn't have animations. And that's why I just want to like beat it into people's heads that this is a better game. This is the newer game. This is a successor to APOC 1 because it has all these new things and they're going to be tweaked to perfection and it's going to be wonderful. So animations are going to be awesome because doing actions will require animations. Weapon fire and all this fun stuff are going to have animations because it adds better sense to the game.
What weapons do you hope will be in APOC 2?
Simply put, bullpups. I want some freaking bullpups, please. Like, we have so many weapons where the magazine is in front of the weapon, and adding some bullpups like an AUG, TAR, Cage, 2002, anything really would just be awesome, because most bullpups are already chambered in either 5.56, 7.62, so they already fit the chambers. Yeah. So plus most of them can fit Sten mags, so we can definitely, I feel, should put in at least one or two bullpups just to help add it to the game, in my opinion.
Yeah, and like you said, with the magazines and ammo system, if they fit, you know, and why not add it?
Or yeah, exactly.
Try new things, you know?
We're not going to have to be adding like these new complicated rounds or anything, because it already all fits in within the game.
What are you looking forward to most about Apocalypse Rising 2?
I would say a new experience. Being able to go from APOC 1 to APOC 2 and being able to experience it for the first time. It was around the era of version 4.5.4 when Gus added vehicles to amend. And like that Christmas day, it was December 24th. And I recall like sitting on the computer and like hearing about this, and the update came out, and I like, people are, you know, sitting around the house, like, you know, celebrating the fact that it's Christmas Eve. And I'm here sitting playing APOC because there are vehicles.
Yeah,
like it was awesome. And I guess it's just the fact that it was new and that it made me like so excited to play the game. Like when 5.0 came out, it was a whole new map. So that kind of feeling, that new experience, is what really hits me.
So what can current APOC players look forward to in Apocalypse Rising 2? Things that like are similar, that are going to try to stay kind of similar with Apocalypse Rising 2.
I think the most important thing from transitioning to APOC 1 to APOC 2 is that it's made by the same people. So you're not switching out a bunch of different people you don't know who are like developing some new game. We're still the same people, and we still know what we want. And the dream of APOC is becoming real because we're able to do so much more.
Do you think there should be snipers in Apocalypse Rising 2?
It really depends on like everything, basically, the way it's implemented. A one-shot kill sort of thing would only make sense in the head, especially for a game like this where, you know, three shots in the head will kill you. So a sniper would have to be balanced enough that it's not overpowered. But that's why something like bullet drop will actually make it so when you hit someone in the head, it's rewarding because you know you took away a lot of damage. Mm-hmm. Going back to the whole concept of them, I think being able to take like a bolt action rifle, for example, and attach a civilian, maybe like a makeshift kind of scope to it would really make it a sniper rifle. Of course, there are already going to be, you could say, marksman rifles, because of course, you know, anything that's really kind of a battle rifle can be used as a marksman rifle, like the M14. But in terms of a sniper rifle, I think marksman rifles will really fulfill that purpose better than a sniper rifle, because it might be bolt action, and also because most sniper rifles have a larger round than something that's 7.62.
So what do you want base building to be like? Like, think of this one here.
I've actually haven't got thought much about this one, because base building is obviously something that was in APOC 1, and I definitely hope it's in APOC 2. I just wonder how it's going to be done with how the game runs. So currently, I haven't given it much thought, because it seems like it's not as important as it will be later on, because we want to make it better than APOC 1, but we also want to make it make sense.
Yeah, instead of having entrench, you know, flying around bricks.
Exactly. Yeah. Oh, like when you can entrench items. Oof.
Make yourself go high in the sky.
With tires or something. Yeah, stuff like that. Yeah. It's a bit annoying.
What are some things you wish were in APOC 1 that will be in Apocalypse Rising 2, or you hope to be in Apocalypse Rising 2? So think about like older things that people were wanting in Apocalypse Rising 1. Like think of like anything that will or you want to be in Apocalypse Rising 2.
Snipers and helicopters. That was always the joke that like we need snipers, we need helicopters, you know, ghillie suits, you know, grass and all that. But I mean, I just want the same experience. It per se, I want it to feel like APOC, but I want it to feel like a better, newer APOC.
So what would you like to see with Apocalypse Rising 2 VIP servers once the game's out?
or when VIP servers are added.
I guess one of the coolest things about Apox VIP servers is the amount of, well, ever since they've been getting updates, is the amount of freedom and the amount of things you can do with them. Recently, we added the ability to make an ARCL style kind of private server battle, because people have been, you know, like if you look in the Discord or anywhere, it's just 2v2 anyone, 5v5 anyone. Like everyone loves squad battling in Apoc because of them three taps. So giving people the ability to do something like that was cool. And with Apoc and a new sense of combat and the way things are going to be, I think giving players the ability to change how the game works by buying private servers will not only increase people's want to
and replayability, you know, for
sure. Absolutely. So I think it's just really good to give people more choice and more abilities in terms of private servers. Yeah, exactly.
And speaking of three tapping is something that players really like in Apocalypse Rising. Do you think it will be in Apoc 2? With maybe the same guns or the same ammo type?
Well, to answer that question, I'd have to go into what I believe in Apoc is that I don't believe there is a skill ceiling in Apoc. Apoc's combat and Apoc's gameplay doesn't really value much someone's ability to play. Yes, people can three tap, and some people, like we can see in ARCL, are very, very skilled in it. Yeah. But something like three tapping, I should say, is really it's really centered towards Apoc 1, and because of how the way the weapons work and recoil and everything. So with Apoc 2, hitting a three tap
might be more difficult, you know, especially with the recoil.
Exactly, but that's there's also the question: is it actually going to be a three tap? Is it going to be a two tap?
Is the damage going to be the same?
Is the combat even going to be the same? Which it probably isn't.
And along with like what you're saying, with everything that's going to be new in Apoc 2, like I really don't think players are going to be like, oh, I can't three tap. Well, everything's completely different. You know, it's like, yeah. I don't think even players are going to be thinking about three tapping. You know,
people might reserve themselves not to see who can three tap the fastest, but who can get there for this kill because of maybe bullet drop.
Or who can actually land the shot, you know, at this range. Yeah. So what are some things you wish you could tell people about Apocalypse Rising 2 that they may be thinking otherwise?
When that comes to mind, I really right away think of exploiting, and that fact that everyone associates Apocalypse Rising with being exploitable and just ruined because of exploiters, whereas Apoc 2 is going to have, and let me get close to the mic, it's not going to have code from 2012. So exploiting and Apoc 2, no, please. Okay, don't compare Apoc. You can compare Apoc 1 with exploiting, but please don't compare Apoc 2 with going to be exploitable because new code, we're able to do more. Yeah, we're going to have a lot more functionality and a lot more choices, and we can actually stop things like this without doing something stupid or not being able to, like being in a box, like we can't do anything about it.
So going a little off topic here, problem with Apoc, how it was hacked.
From what I know, which isn't much because I personally don't code, if I were to think about it, I would associate it with two things. One is that the legacy map was stolen and it was multiplied. So anyone who actually knew how to code, we would be able to go into Apoc's code and find out how it works and maybe find weaknesses or something. But to further upon that point, Apoc's code is from 2012. It's very old.
Exactly.
It was written by Keth, and then Hublox 2 kind of like came into a room. Like there's the one gif of I don't remember the show, where a guy walks into a room with a box of pizza, and there's just havoc everywhere. There's fire. The one guy's swinging something. It's almost, I feel like that's what comes to
you
mind
walk
when
into
it comes
complete
to
madness. Yeah, with the old code.
Yeah. I mean, because Hublox 2 came in here, and here's this 2012 code.
So a lot of people compare Apocalypse Rising 2 to Unturn. give us something that would make us not really want to compare it to Unturn anymore. Because you know all those people that are like, oh, Apoc 2 is Unturn. He's copying Unturn. You know?
Okay,
like,
I completely understand. And to be fair, we joke around with Gus a lot. Like when we'll build something and like where Gus will show something, we're like, wow, Gus, that looks all like Unturned. But we do it just jokingly. I mean, like the fact that some things may look like Unturned isn't because we're copying Unturned. It's just because we see that like what we build just ends up being like close to Unturned because Unturned has something. It's like if I made a game and I just like made everything, like I made as much stuff as possible within that genre of a game, and then someone else went out there and made a new game and added some of the stuff I had from that game because they felt it fit in. And so, then people could say, hey, did you copy? Like,
so it's like Family Guy copying The Simpsons. It's like exactly. They've already done it first.
Yes, that's actually a good point.
True. And you, when you think of the two, they're not really that similar at all, you know, like final products, you know?
Yeah. So we're not copying APOC 2. We just see come up with a lot of good things that fit into APOC 2 that Unturned already has because Nelson was really smart in adding stuff because it fits in well to the game.
All right. So can you explain the inventory system? The Pocket Fries 2 inventory system compared to our current one?
Well, a lot of stuff in terms of UI and stuff is being designed by Bluest. So, you know, it's very nice. So, yeah. It's because Bluest is a perfectionist per se, like because he knows design and he knows how to design well. So the inventory system and the UI is going to look really nice because Bluest has a good sense in terms of like that. So the inventory system will be more functional in terms of a grid system. So you'll find something on the ground and you'll be able to find it within like the inventory, the right side of the kind of like grid system, and you'll be able to put it in within your inventory stuff. And I just want to preface this because it's a really smart design and so many games are using a grid system. For example, like I think of Escape from Tarkov when I think of a grid system, or Stalker, which was like kind of like the predecessor, because Stalker, I don't know if it was the first game, but in my eyes, it perfected the grid system because of the way the item works worked and everything. So I think the fact that APOC might, or at least some part of the inventory system might go into a grid system is really smart because it works well with a game where you have loot you can pick up.
So while I have a little proposition here, can I make the eating and drinking sounds for Apocalypse Rising 2?
Oh, I'm sorry, and I know this means a lot to you, but Marco has first priority in terms of making sounds. No one, and I'm sorry, but no one can really match up to his game and his good taste in making sounds. Like, I'm sorry, but Marco is just... he's just that good, you know. Like he just probably telekinetically killed you right there. I don't know, but Marco is just that good at making sounds that he has to be the one to make sounds if we're going to use a human.
Wow, I got a question.
Oh, go ahead.
Is there gonna be like a difference with the weapons? Like and you know the game 7 Days to Die, how you have to create the weapon and find the parts for the weapon. Is there ever gonna be a concept like that in this game?
So you're saying like you could find like an M4 upper and you might need to go find the lower somewhere in order to complete the weapon. I feel like that really works a lot better in a game like 7 Days to Die, or like, and I love this game so much I can't stop quoting it, Escape from Tarkov.
Makes the game more difficult, you know, wouldn't really be suited to
especially players. For kids. Yeah, if like a kid plays it, like they can walk around and they're like, M4 upper, what is this? It's a waste of time. You know, like I got things to do, bandits to kill, you know, food to scavenge, you know. So I mean, like, timing, and I don't know if it'll really fit the game.
So what do you want to see with things like achievements and like the achievements and badges in Apocalypse Rising 2?
Those are really fun to think of and make if they're like special ones. Obviously, we don't want to make them stupid, like, you know, like kill 15 bandits at exactly 6 a.m. or something. But I mean, we want to make them, you know, we want to give people more replay value, more of a sense, more of a goal to actually strive for.
Yeah.
Strive.
Oh, no.
To actually go for in terms of the game. No, don't worry. No, I'm not going there. But we want to make something for people to actually go towards and like be like, oh, crap. Like, dude, I'm so close to getting this badge or like this achievement, and it's like really cool.
Yeah.
I don't see people really showing off, but I guess it just, you know, it's fun to do while you're playing the game to be able to go and try to get
it. Yeah, it's important to the game. Yeah. What would you want to see in a tutorial for Apocalypse Rising 2? Because, you know, do we have a tutorial in the current Apoc? I know we did at one point, but it was very simple. You know, it didn't really go into too much depth, you know.
I'm happy that in the original Apoc there was a tutorial, but Apoc 2 definitely needs a tutorial because Gus brought this up with us before about like one time where his dad played the game and like he like couldn't understand like how to do anything. And thing is, especially if you think about like newer players trying to play the game or something, I mean, good luck. In some cases, maybe, because I mean, you might not know how to do things or why certain things happen. So giving players an actual like quality tutorial that explains the game well, but not without taking up a lot of their time, so they get bored and they just, you know, just pass through everything just so they can play the game or something, is really important, because you want to be able to show players that we want to make sure they have a good experience without taking up a lot of their time.
All right, last question.
What do you want to see with combat in Apocalypse Rising 2?
Okay. So combat is extremely important for a game like this, because even though it's not like, it's not hyper realistic, it's not going to be like stupidly realistic or anything, obviously, and it's still going to be, you know, in this sense, an arcade game. So you want people to actually be able to, you know, move around in a well-designed manner where the game is still fun, the game is replayable, and it feels nice. That's the thing. The game needs to feel good. We want to balance the game out, because if I take this PPSH, for example, I mean, it has, what, full mag, it has 35 rounds. And if you have a Mosin right now and you shoot me once, like, okay, Gooby shoots me, right? Well, it sucks for him because I have a PPSH and he's dead. Like, it's just... You see how unfair that? Mm-hmm. Like, I, it's unfair, but it makes sense.
Yeah.
Because if I'm in close quarters, he's dead. If I'm all the way, like, on the other side, well, not other side of the map, but if I'm really far away and I'm trying to, like, snipe him with a PPSH, I mean, good luck.
Yeah.
So you want the combat to be balanced, and you want it to make sense. And I think that with the way Apex 2 is working, it should be really good.
All right. Well, so we had some great questions here for Zealience, and thank you so much for coming on for this Q&A video for Apocalypse Rising 2.
Mm-hmm. My pleasure.
If you guys do want us to make another video, leave a comment or a question about what you would like to ask for the next video. So thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget to hit that like button and subscribe for more of these interview type videos for Apocalypse Rising 2. Peace out, guys.
Peace out.